Welcome back to the Spin Room, and we're here with Mideast Crossfire, the live debate where our guests will be taking shots over whether President Donald Trump should try to roll up his sleeves and impose peace here between Israel and the Palestinians. Trump wants the deal of the century. The Palestinians are dismissing it as the snub of the century, and Israel hoping its best friend in the White House won't pressure it to make painful concessions. So who better to debate this than our two roaring cannons, Yossi Beilin, former Justice Minister and Deputy Foreign Minister and architect of the Oslo Accords, and Yishai Fleisher, spokesman for the Jewish settler community in Hebron. The rules are clear. Dr. Beilin, you have 1 minute. Should Trump try to enter this field, roll up his sleeves, and make peace between Israel and the Palestinians?
Of course he should. I mean, he is the head of the free world. You have here a problem which is intricate, going on and on for 70 years. And almost every American president tried his hands, rightly so. He promised to do that. And you should do that, but not to impose, because you cannot impose peace as you cannot impose love. There is a limit to imposition.
Shai, do you believe President Trump should try to wade in here and strike the ultimate deal?
Making a deal is a good thing in general, but nothing to do with land concessions. Look at North Korea. Nobody's asking South Korea to give away tracts of land to North Korea. Nobody would accept that. And I think that Dr. Beilin's general assumption is that President Trump would try to force some kind of land concessions. That we're against. We think that that is a failed policy. Land for peace is a failed policy. The Gaza withdrawal proved it. It proves it every single day that giving away land to the PA means giving it away to Hamas. And we think that's unjust, and we think that's just going to end up what it has ended up, which is giving forward bases to the jihad in our ancestral homeland.
Dr. Beilin, let's deal with this directly, because the Middle East peace process has been stuck ever since the Oslo process began to unravel. What can Donald Trump do this time to make sure we're not repeating the same failed experiments of the past?
Well, here, this is the big question. Can he suggest something new, or is he going just to repeat the obvious solution, which is there, I would say, since the Clinton parameters? And I believe that, and I hope, that his team will come up with a new idea which will have to be a challenge for both sides. For example, the idea of an Israeli-Palestinian confederation, which will deal with security, which will deal with the settlers who would like to remain under the Palestinian state, and with coordination on natural resources and other things. This is something which has not been negotiated, which has been there somewhere hanging in the air. And I think that it is about time.
So just to clarify, do you think that Donald Trump stands a chance if instead of trying the previous format of summits and direct peace talks for the traditional format of two-state solution, he tries to pull a rabbit out of his hat, dramatic new idea, Israeli-Palestinian confederation?
If it is possible for the team. I don't know whether this is their aim. It is secretive and we don't get any information about it. But I believe that the big deal would be to suggest something which is different a little bit from what has been suggested so far.
Yishai, there we go. We have Dr. Beilin agreeing with you here. He's not talking about the same formulations as the past. We're going to have an Israeli-Palestinian confederation. You can stay put in Hebron.
I'm very surprised to hear Dr. Beilin speak like this. I would have thought that he, being the architect of the Oslo Accords, would have called for that same type of formula. And I'm surprised and actually pleased to hear him say that, basically, in other words, that has failed. Giving away land to the Palestinian Authority is a bad idea. Creation of a Palestinian Authority.
Let's stop here. Dr. Beilin, are you on the record? No, because I don't want him to put words in your mouth. Are you on the record of saying the Oslo process failed?
Well, for sure, it did not bring up the solution. I mean, it was an interim solution which became a permanent one because of the rightist governments. But here, the idea is of two separate sovereign states. There will be a border between us, but a border which will enable us to live together under an umbrella of a confederation.
This is living under the umbrella.
Let me go back to what I was starting to say, which is Dr. Beilin is saying, with a lot of words, a simple thing, which is the two-state solution failed. Now he's got a new formula, and I'm happy that we're at least thinking creatively. You know, Dr. Beilin is one of the people who came up with Birthright, and so he's a creative thinker. When it comes to two-state, this was wrong. He was wrong. This whole process was wrong. Ended up killing 1,500 Israelis. Now it's time for something new. So confederation with the Palestinians is one idea. Another one is maybe Jordan is Palestine. Really a Palestinian state, 80% Palestinians. Maybe they could give their passports back to the people they took it away from, the Palestinians in 1984. Let them remain in Judea and Samaria. When we become sovereign there, we'll assert sovereignty over Judea and Samaria. And then Jordan will be the place that they vote, that they air out their democratic wishes and wills, but they remain put as residents of the state of Israel. That's just an idea. I wrote an article in New York Times with five alternatives.
Let's pause then on that idea. Dr. Beilin, is there any possibility possibility for Donald Trump to make peace on the basis of those guidelines?
Well, there is no chance. I mean, Jordan gave up on the 31st of July, 88, on the West Bank, and will never get it back. And they have good reasons for that. You cannot have peace between us and the Palestinians on the account of the Jordanians who do not want it. The question is about, not about borders or territory for peace. It is about territory for a Jewish and democratic state. If we are going to be a minority of Jews ruling a majority of Palestinians, it is the end of Zionist democracy. And I don't want to leave to my children and grandchildren such a state.
Yishai Fleisher, you're hoping that Donald Trump will propose a solution that would mean the end of the Zionist enterprise because we become a minority in a Muslim-majority state.
I first think that's not true, and there's a lot of contested facts about how many Jews and Arabs are there, respectively.
The trends seem pretty indisputable.
No, that's not true. They are disputed. They are, in fact, disputed. And some people
say
there's
a serious cross of demography,
people, that's
Yishai.
That's not true what you're saying, and there are serious demographers on the other side. Be that as it may, I'm pretty surprised to hear that there's new ideas coming out of the left. But basically, what really is behind these words is, let's gerrymander our borders to shrink them. Shrink them so it's just Jews. So in the discussion of giving rights to everybody, what he really means is, I want less Israel, a smaller Israel that will just give Jews
a democratic rights. Just to clarify, are you proposing that Donald Trump put a plan on the agenda which would include a single binational state between the river and the sea, in which the Palestinians would all become full citizens of Israel with equal rights? I emphasize that at the end.
That is not what I said. I don't know how you would have gotten that. That's an interesting way to understand.
Well,
you suggested that
Israel annex Judea and Samaria.
And with the citizenship of Jordan. Or another option is...
But why should they not be citizens of the government under which they serve? That's the essence of democracy.
Yeah, but this is not just a Jewish and democratic state. It's actually a Jewish ethnic state defending the Jewish minority in a region of 400 million Arabs in 22 Arab countries. So first and foremost, this country is here to defend Jewish people and to live in its ancestral homeland. We are the indigenous people of this land. We have every right here. Yes, there's other minorities, and sadly some of those minorities have jihadist tendencies. We're going to have to figure out a way
to do that. Okay, Shai Fleisher proposing here that Donald Trump put a plan on the agenda for a single state in which
absolutely
the Palestinians do not become equal citizens of the new state. Dr. Beilin, just before the break, Mr. Fleisher here was presenting to us a scenario in which Donald Trump should say there will be one state between the river and the sea. It will be a Jewish ethnic state, and the Palestinians will have no voting rights.
Well, I'm glad to hear it, because this is a very clear voice of the extreme right. This is the vision that they want. And I'm telling you, this is not why my parents came to this land. This is not why I'm here and my family is here. And I don't want to live. I don't want to live in a Jewish state which doesn't allow the minorities the same rights as it allows to Jews.
But that's exactly what you were offering. You were offering to pull out of those areas and create a jihadist state right next door so you could be in your little Jewish ghetto so it would be exactly the way you want it to be. That's all you're offering, shrinking away. I say more Jewish sovereignty, more rights for people. When you created Palestine, when you created the PA, you didn't give people more rights. You took away their rights. The Palestinian Authority is a bully organization. It suppresses people's rights. You didn't do anything beautiful. You put most of the people under the worst conditions that they can't even speak, they can't have any, they don't have any freedoms. So please, don't do me a favor. You didn't create a beautiful thing, and you created a perpetual war. I'm saying a strong Jewish state, a bigger Jewish state,
more rights. Dr. Beilin, this is a damning indictment, the idea that even if we create two states, the people living on the other side of that border aren't necessarily going to be living in a democratic state. No guarantee they'll have more rights than now.
I mean, there is a limit.
Tough luck. The question is, if you are interested in human rights and democracy, you create another state that has no human rights.
There is a limit to what we can do. We can allow them to have their own state. We can shrink, it is true, our own land in order to have a Jewish majority. If after that they choose to have an authoritarian regime or whatever, as long as they don't fight against
us. It's not exactly the people's
regime.
Choice, though, is it?
Yeah, it's not. Their choice was taken away from them. When you empowered Yasser Arafat, you empowered the worst.
Please let Dr. Beilin answer.
I did not disturb.
Sir.
I'm really glad that you are here, and this is what you are telling the world. We want a Jewish minority dominating a big Palestinian majority without their rights. This is what you say. And what I'm saying is that I'm ready to withdraw from the West Bank in order to have a Jewish state and Palestinian state under a confederation, if they wish so. If they don't want so, it will be just two-state solution without a confederation. And if they prefer not to have a democracy, I will not impose it on them, because after all, I'm selfish And nationally, this is what I need. I need a Jewish and democratic state.
Yishai, there is a name for an ethnic minority that decides to run a state under rules that prioritize that particular ethnic minority while depriving the majority of its rights. Can you guess its name?
Yeah, you're probably referring to apartheid, but that's absolutely absurd. What we're talking about is a region, again, with 400 million Arabs, a tiny little
that's
autonomy.
Not relevant to the
it's
question
quite,
of minority
it's
rule
quite,
on a purely
it's
ethnic
quite
basis,
relevant
isn't
because
it,
we are the minority. We are the minority in this region. We wouldn't establish an Israel to create Arab rights, to make Arab rights. Your grandparents and parents didn't come here to give Arab rights. Nobody came out of the Holocaust to make a democracy for the Arabs. It's absurd what he's saying.
Sorry,
we came back to live.
To
we came back
Jews
to live
came
in Hebron and
came to build an enlightened
no,
state founded on the vision of justice
people.
Of the prophets.
We came to protect.
I'm quoting Israel's Declaration of Independence.
Please, the Declaration of Independence is there to create a Jewish state to protect our Jewish minority in this region. These talk about giving rights. He didn't give any rights. He created a 23rd Arab state. It suppressed its own people. Then it attacked us mercilessly, and we're warring with
but
it right
Yishai,
now.
Let me the understand something. Let me understand
even,
here. Donald Trump
here.
Means business. He's going to put something on the table. The Arab states could well support it, could well pressure the Palestinians to accepting it. But if Israel rejects it in the name of continuing a messianic vision of settlement expansion and wanting to build one state in which a minority, an ethnic minority, rules over the majority, Israel is going to be in very serious trouble, is
you
it
not? You are trying to scare us. We are not an ethnic. We are not ruling a majority here. We are the minority trying to defend ourselves. Who's messianic? The people that want to still give away land away? Haven't they learned from the Gaza? To me, it's a chutzpah that you have a person sitting here with us who's going to offer to us, let's give away more land. You know, when I'm on an airplane.
Yossi Beilin, how do you respond to this argument that the idea of peace is in itself a messianic fantasy?
I'll tell you something. This debate is not a real debate. It's not a debate between two people who are ready to compromise on land, but say you are not compromising enough, you need more for security, which is something like, let us say, the Prime Minister and myself. Here you have a vision, which is, in my view, frightening, because the same thing was said by the whites in South Africa. They said, we are a minority in a black majority. You cannot speak about South Africa as such, but about Africa at large. So it's the same kind of vision. And thanks heaven that only a minority, a small minority in Israel, believes in such a vision.
He doesn't know how to count Knesset members. The Knesset today leans to the right. Prime Minister Netanyahu and his government leans to the right. But Donald Trump leads to the right. I am sure that Yossi Beilin was against
the
American recognition of Jerusalem.
But the Prime Minister is still on the record saying that he is in favor, in principle, of a two-state solution.
That's true. And now we're moving away from that. We are now rolling back policy. It's very hard to change policy. Since Yossi Beilin and company made policy in the 90s, it was a dreaded mistake. It ended up with the Gaza Strip.
Do you see the government moving in the inevitable direction of a creeping annexation?
I mean, I don't say creeping. It's not creeping. And by the way, I want to fix one more thing. This is not about Donald Trump. This is about our decision to move forward, be strong, hold on to our land, push back on the jihad, and give more rights to more decent people by freeing them from the jihad that he created, from the Palestinian Authority.
We have to wrap up. It's time for final shot. Yossi Beilin, in a minute, please, your final remarks. Should Donald Trump roll up his sleeves and try to make peace here?
For sure. I mean, I think that he is a person of gestures. He wants very much to suggest something new, and I would encourage him to do it. Don't impose it, because you cannot. But suggest it to both sides.
And if the sides, how do you expect the sides are going to respond to that proposal?
I don't know what is the content. We have to see the content in order to foresee what should be what will be the reaction of both sides.
But no harm in trying. Yishai Fleisher, given what President Trump is likely to suggest, which is not your Jewish ethnocracy scenario, do you think that he should roll up his sleeves and nevertheless try to make peace? Peace, which, by the way, is in the interest of you and your community as much as everyone else.
Do me a favor, don't put words in my mouth, but I do want to say to you that Donald Trump has already shown that, A, he's going to recognize Jerusalem as the capital of Israel, push back on the Iranian jihad, defund UNRWA, defund UNESCO, or leave UNESCO altogether. This is not a man who's going to go for the ho-hum, old-school way of thinking. He's going to do policy changes, policy thinking. He's got Bolton, he's got Friedman, he's got Haley. These are people who know what it means to give away land to the jihad. They know how foolish that is. He's not going to go in that old way.
Okay, gentlemen, thank you very much for that. That brings us to the end of Mideast Crossfire. Thank you very much, honestly, to our guests, Yossi Beilin and Yishai Fleisher.